Last Friday, this bank in Chelmsford was robbed of £6,000. The robber, captured here on film, claimed to be carrying a gun. Yesterday morning, a mother of three was found stabbed to death here at her home in Billericay. The number of murders in Essex is one figure that's gone down, from 11 in 1989 to 9 last year. But overall, the number of crimes went up. Offences such as rape, incest and unlawful sex rose from 122 to 161, a rise of 32%. Robberies were up from 324 to 387. Burglaries rose by 30% to 19,867. Cases of theft and fraud soared by more than 12,000 to nearly 56,500. Overall, a rise of 25%. That's on a par with increases across the home counties, except for Bedfordshire, where crime soared by 31% in 1990. The Chief Constable of Essex described today's figures as very worrying, but said there was a misplaced fear of crime in the county.
The likelihood of being assaulted or indeed attacked in any way is still remote, certainly here in Essex. If you're a young man in the age group 18 to 20 and you go out drinking on a Friday or Saturday, then clearly you're at a higher risk. But for women in the middle-aged group, then the likelihood of being assaulted or attacked is remote in the extreme.
The point that I would like to make, in spite of a very small increase in the number of police officers, their rate of detection has gone up by nearly 14%, which is really quite a remarkable achievement.
Research by the Home Office suggests that the recession and drug dependency have played a part in pushing up crime figures nationally, though Chief Constable Burrow admitted there's no simple explanation or indeed a simple solution to cracking crime. This is Sally Arthie in Essex for Thames News.